Okay, today we would like to talk about those of you who attended the All Night. We started speaking from there, and I would like us to take off from there in that direction. We'll do a quick review, and then we'll continue from there. We were talking about the need for a man to change his or her ways of doing things. And you can all agree with me that things, the way our world is going today, things are not well. Do you agree with me? Things are not very well. The world, things are going out of man's control. There are several things happening that man can no longer control. We have so many situations around the world now that man is just trying to manage it and to live by it. But trying to solve it, the power is not there. We have so many sicknesses and diseases all around our hospitals in the world that is beyond man's control. Man is not able to do anything about those sicknesses. They have no cure for those things. And where are they coming from? Well, we can tell from the word of God, but if you don't know the word of God, you can't tell the source. I know the number one cause of cancer. You know it. Number one cause of cancer is bitterness. You can write it down. If you're a bitter person, get ready for cancer. It's the number one cause. You can do a research on your own. You can do a research. All those who have cancer, go and check their life. They are very angry people, very little thing annoying them. Very soon. And if you're a lady, get ready. You will get cancer. Now they don't even know how to name it. Anywhere the cancer appears, they name it after the part. In your brain. They name it after your brain. Anywhere. If you're a person, everything annoys you, everything you take to heart, get ready for cancer. And those cancers have no cure. They don't. Because God created man to be a happy person. So if you choose to go the other way, well, the other circumstances are there to face you. And there are other causes too of cancer. And all other diseases, there are causes there. If you go, they may diagnose and say, well, it's one food to eat and whatever. Well, it's good. The food too may be a cause, but the number one cause of cancer. You can do a research. Most of you are going to be doctors at the hospital. Use this to do a research. Check their life and see how they lead. They are bitter people. They have bitterness within their spirit. And bitterness is the number one killer of the human soul. If you're a bitter person, get ready. You live a very, very, very hard life. So, there is a need for man to change the way we do things. The way we were doing things many years back, if you do the same thing today, it's not working. The formulas, the principles that the world put to work many years back, and they got a great result. If you put those principles and those rules, laws, Archimedes' laws, there are so many laws around the world. If you put those laws to work today, it's just like it's not working. For that reason, there is a need for man to change the way we do things. We need to redefine life. And in the process of redefining life, you can only find the new definitions in the Word of God. It's only the Word of God that have those definitions. So you must know the Word of God for yourself. You need to understand the Word of God for yourself. And I gave you some areas with which you need to redefine life. All the definitions we have in our books, it was designed by somebody. Somebody sat down and wrote it. Most of them are wrong. I told you most of the things we are studying in school, they are wrong. They are wrong. Those of you who are new, in case you hear anything and you have any question, write it down. After service, see me, let me explain to you, okay? Most of the things we are studying, they are wrong. Example, many years back, they said we have 9 planets. And people had PhD studying 9 planets, right? Later on, they came out and said, you know something, we are very sorry, it's not 9, it's now 8. Pluto is no longer a planet. But people have PhD on 9 planets. So all this while, they spend all their lives studying a lie. And they have PhD on a lie. So just imagine you study such a lie and you put it to work. You'll get a wrong result in your life. So many of us, we are being trained, we are reading the wrong things and planning to go and apply it in our marriage. Most of you have the formula, you say, oh, me, when I marry, you have your own things. Things you'll be doing in the house. Make sure it's in accordance with the word of God, else it will fail, it won't work. When you ask your parents, they apply some of those things and their marriages are not working. They are in hell in the marriage. Later on, they came out again and said, you know something, the planets are no longer 8. They are actually many. You see it? But people had PhD. They studied. They made a lot of money studying 9 planets. They thought that was all there is, but it is not. So just imagine those days, they wrote in exam. They asked in a question in an exam, and they said, how many planets do we have? And somebody said, well, so many, they will mark you off. Yet you were actually right. They will mark you wrong. That is why I always tell you people, you are the best student. Say it to yourself, mention your name and tell yourself, I am the best student. Or if you don't remember your name, you can mention my name. Say, Naya, you are the best student. Tell yourself, I am the best student. Some of you don't believe it. Say, me, I know myself. I can't say this, I'm the best student, but I'm still scoring 30% in class. Who told you? The best student is not measured by the amount you score in examination. Can I give you a proof? Science is busy looking for the source of life. They study this thing over more than 3,000 years now. They are looking for source of life. Where is life from? But some, all of you here, you can tell. Life comes from God. So you are the best student. What science is yet to discover, you know it already. So best student is not measured by the one who scored 100% in examination. No. That is not. So believe in yourself. You are the best student. Okay? When you write examination, whatever result comes out, that's it. You are the best. You are still the best. And so what if I score 0? You are still the best. Do you know how many things you know that were not on that question paper? If they were to ask questions that you know on that paper, you will score more than 100. The one they ask is rather accidentally, that is, you are yet to read it. You see, that was what make you score 0. But you are more than that. So you need to change. And one area man has to change is the mind. Is the mind. Today, time will not permit me to talk about the mind. But the mind is the mediator between the human spirit and the human body. If your spirit being wants to communicate to your body, it comes through your mind. Then your mind tells your body, this is what the spirit wants to do. Do you know you are a spirit being? You don't know. You are a spirit being. You only live in your body. Your body is just your house. But you are a spirit being. So if your spirit wants to do anything, your spirit wants to go out of this room. That is the decision of the spirit. I want to go out of this room. Then your spirit being will communicate to your mind. I want to get out of the room. Then your mind will begin to communicate to the rest of the body which areas are responsible for going out of the room. Then you begin to take the action. The same way, when you see something, you know, our 5 senses are the gateway to the human spirit. So if your spirit wants to see what is happening outside, around the world, what is happening around you, you use your eyes. And when your eyes pick up the picture, it goes through your mind to be communicated back to your spirit. So the mind, as part of the human body, is very, very important. And I gave you the greatest limitation of the mind at the online, those of you who were there. And for the sake of those of you who were not there, I'll tell you again. As great as the human mind is, it has one big limitation. What is it? Who can remember? Yes. The human mind cannot differentiate between what is real and what is not real. That is why when you have a dream, the mind cannot recognize the fact that this is just a dream. Sometimes you wake up panicking and crying, fear, yet it was just a dream. But the mind cannot recognize it that way. The same way, the realities around us, our mind cannot tell this is reality and this is not reality. The mind cannot do that. That is the limitation of the mind. It can't tell the difference between what is real and what is not real. That is why somebody can see the shadow and begin to run away. He's afraid of his own shadow. Yet it's just a shadow, even your own shadow, especially kids. It's your own shadow. That is why in the darkness, you can get in sometimes you are afraid. Yes, it was just a flash of light. That is the limitation of the mind. It can't tell. This is just something normal. The mind cannot. But you know something, that is the reason why you need to train your mind. You need to train your mind. The mind needs to be trained. For this reason, school was designed so that you can get the opportunity to train your mind. You can understand me because you were educated. Your mind is trained to understand English. Even if the accent is not good, at least you can manage it. I'm from America, so I know my accent is good. Someone said, me, I knew you, but you just said you are from Ghana. Why am I myself? I said I'm from America. What is your problem? Okay, so you need to train your mind. And the word of God tells us to renew our mind. What is the reason for renew? If you are going to renew something, it means there is something there already, right? Yes, when we were born, according to the society you found yourself, according to the type of parent you had, will determine a type of programming you will have in your mind. You were born empty. Every child believes you can jump from the top of the building down, and everything will be cool. That's the belief of a child. But along the way, every child believes their parents are the richest people in the persons in the community. So they will say, "Dad, you know something, I need a car." Because they believe that dad is the richest guy. Children believe all possibilities. But along the way, the parents will begin to train them. You know something? When you jump down, you will die. When you drink this, you will die. It's called poison. And they will begin to train the child, give the child information. They will tell the child all manner of things. And sometimes in the process of telling us these things, they wrongly program us. Some of us were programmed for failure. Things you were told by your parents and the society and the books and those things you read, some of them, if you put them to work, you will have you will fail in life because it won't work. You were given the wrong information. For that cause, God said in His word, man should renew his mind to learn new things now. And one of them is what I just told you. You are the best student. And you need to catch this and put it in your mind now and now. You are the best student. There is no other best student anywhere. When they ask you in your class, "Oh, who is the best student?" Say, "It's me." And it is you. You know so many things that even the teacher standing in front of you does not know. So the teacher does not have the right to say, "Well, you are not the best student." No. Should we ask some questions, you will be able to answer. Even your teacher cannot. So he can't grade you. Maybe in studying Chinese language, well, somebody may be scoring better than the other. But that's not the case. When we were studying Chinese language, there were so many people who scored 99, 98. Now, even now, they can't speak Chinese. They were only good in the class. But when it comes to the oral, they are not good. Do we need the writing? No, when we show up at the place, we are going to speak. We are not going to show exam papers. You are the best student. So you must always believe in yourself that you are the best. And those are the things you need to begin to renew your mind with. And you need to begin to see life from the positive side. Positive life is possible. And I learned it from the word of God. Society where I grew, they never told me of any possibility. They tell you, no, it depends on your parents. When your parents are poor, you will be poor. Those are the things they told us. You know something, there are things you can't do because you came from a village, you are a village boy. Leave it for those who come from the city. Those are the things we were told. And when they were telling us those things, do you know what they were doing? They were wrongly programming us. They were giving you the wrong program. And I know, according to whatever country or wherever you grew, the same thing, you have some wrong programmings within you. You have them. So there is a need to renew it with the Word of God. You need to apply the Word of God to your life to renew the way you think. To renew the way you think. The way you talk. The way you do things. You need to renew your mind. Because your mind controls you. So if your mind is wrongly programmed, I told you during the all night that your first response to every situation will determine how far the situation will go. If you get a report and say, I'm dead, well, you will die. That was what you said, you will die. So for that cause, you need to program your mind. Because the Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. That is to say, whatever your heart is full of, that is what you speak out. What do you have within you? When you hear any situation, it's what you utter out. If you want to know the spiritual level of a person, let the person talk for 2-3 minutes. And the way and the direction the person will talk, you can use it to determine his spiritual level. The person will begin to talk fear, unbelief, impossibility. Yes, that's the type of person he is. Somebody just gushing, please, help me, help me. What is the problem? He said, I need 5,000. 5,000. Please, I don't. No, you worsen the case. Don't run away. Tell the person, relax. Just 5,000, you are panicking like this, relax. Even if you don't have the money, tell the person to relax. Offer the person a chair. Say, sit down. Sit down. Offer some drink. And offer some food. What are you doing? You are trying to calm the situation down. Yeah, the situation may be great, 5,000 already. You may not have it. Tell the person, you calm down. Just 5,000 and you are panicking like this. Mm-hmm. Let the person eat, drink. And after all those things, you say, you know something. I don't have 5,000 right now. Don't say I don't have 5,000. Say right now, because you have. Say I don't have 5,000 right now. But I think the panic will not solve the problem. It's rather than you put yourself together and we begin to look for a way to solve the problem. Cry will not solve the problem. You stop crying. I'm going to sort my friends and friends and you to continue to ask from your friends and let's put ourselves together and clear this thing. That's it. If the person gets into your room and if I tell you yourself, you jump through the window, what are you going to do? No, don't let any amount of money intimidate you. Don't. Grow big enough that no amount of money will intimidate you. Ever since you were born till today, do you know how much was spent on you till today? So what is your problem? Who told you you are poor? You are not poor. You know how much? If you were to quantify all the food, clothes, everything, the water, everything you drank, you ate till today, if you were to quantify all of them, do you know how much value you cost? You being on earth, do you know how much you have cost the earth? You have no idea. You have no idea. That's why you don't have the right to call yourself, I'm a poor person. No. If you say such a thing, you are insulting yourself. You are not poor. And you need to change your mind in case you don't know it. Well, today I'll be talking in one area. I want us to close very on time. I told you during the all night that a man needs, write it down, a man needs focus into the future. Those of you who attended the all night, I think you have it already. A man needs focus into the future. Otherwise, in the all night I say, or else, or anything, it's the same statement. The mind needs focus into the future. Otherwise, it will replace itself with the past. If you don't have focus into the future, your mind will always glory in the past. Most of us, the only thing we know we can talk about is our dead dad, our dead parents, our primary school, our old friends, our senior high school best friend. Those are the things we talk about. Your mind is replacing your whole life with the past, and you need to do something about it quickly. Always, the human mind has to always have focus into the future, be looking at something very far away and moving towards it. If you don't have such a thing in your life, always your mind will keep thinking about the past. You will keep glorying in the first boyfriend you had. That will be your glory. Yet you have a new boyfriend, but no, your mind is in the past. So you will always keep glorying in the old boyfriend. People even take it to their marriage home. The lady is married, but always, if it were to be that first guy. And men to do it. After married to a nice lady, still thinking about that first girlfriend. If this were to be my woman, things wouldn't be like this one. You know something? Your mind has replaced itself with the past. Anytime all you think about is about things in the past, you need to wake up, you need to come back. Most of you, your rooms, what you have is old pictures all around the wall, old, when you were 2 years. And every day you look at it, you are so excited about when you were 2 years. Your high school picture is all you look through. What about today? What about today? Some of you even have cars in your room you place on your wall that is no longer in use. But you admire it so much. Yet the car is no longer in use. Go and get the latest car picture and place it in your room. So anytime you look at it, your spirit will begin to expand towards it. Some of you, it's Archimedes you have on your wall. Archimedes is dead. You know better than Archimedes. You know, as great as he was, you know so many things he doesn't know. But he's the one you admire, is on your wall. Anytime you say, Archimedes. You know all his laws and principles, you know him. You even know, those are dead people, leave them to go. Get your own picture and paste it on your own wall. Anytime you look at yourself, you say, you know something, you are going far in life. You are going far. Anytime you look at a picture, tell yourself, you know something, this is just the beginning. Who are you talking to? You are blessing yourself on the wall. Some of you is cartoons you have on your wall, cartoons. And you have dreams and you are seeing some funny things, you say you don't understand why. It's the things on the wall. It's true. You know, what you see most, what you hear most, what you feel more, what you touch more, what you taste more, those are the things that determine the happiness in your life. There are things I've never seen before. When they talk about it, I have no idea. There is no way I'll be able to fear any of those things. As fearful as they may be, I will not fear it. I don't know anything about it. You need to, you know, things you look at is very, very important. It is. It is. So you need to have focus. You need to have plans into the future. Write your future plans down. What do you want to do? What do you want to be? Write it down. And from time to time, take the book, open it and read it. Then that way your mind will be programmed. You are going somewhere. Sometimes when you read some of those things, you'll be like, no, if I want to be a doctor, and from the way I'm studying today, I'm not sure I can be a doctor. Then you wake up and begin to study well. Do you want to be any ordinary doctor? Well, if that is the case, then you can study anyhow. But if you want to be a good doctor, then you need to study well. And you need to write some of those things that from time to time you open the book and you read it. And after reading, you put your hands on it and you pray. You say, in the name of Jesus, things I have written here, they will all come to pass in my life. I'll be the best doctor. I'll be the best, whatever course you are doing, you say you'll be the best. That your whole country will hear of you. The whole world will hear of me. I will be the best. I will be the first. Wherever I am the best and I am the first. You declare those words upon your own self. You are blessing yourself. I always tell you people, you don't need any pastor to bless you. you have the right and the power to bless yourself. God made every person, every child of God, a prophet. You can prophesy to your own life. You don't need any prophet to give you any anointing oil, anything to be drinking and be eating. No. You can be a prophet. You are the prophet of your own life. However you want to go, wherever you want to go, keep talking in that direction. And your spirit will begin to expand towards it. There are a lot of people, they have great ideas, but other people talk them down. They tell them, you know, something, this is very impossible. And they forget about the idea because somebody talked them down. It was just words spoken to the guy. You can't do it. This is really impossible. And they just put the whole idea somewhere. You see, I was telling you, if you want to be inspired in life, don't look for somebody who has expired. If the person is expired, he cannot inspire you. Always look for people who have motivation, people who can motivate you, people who can always tell you to wake up. I told you, if you have a friend and the friend is comfortable with you, when you are doing the wrong thing, your friend is not pushing you to do anything, you are with the wrong friend. Always be with a friend that will push you. If you are not going to church, will be pressing you. You have to be in church. Those are good friends. Those are good friends. Not people who feel comfortable today when you in church, you send yourself, I even need to. So the two of you just give myself a challenge. It's the next time you will go now. No, don't be with such friends. If you say I didn't go to church and he said you need to run away from him. So you need to have focus into the future. Write something down that you are always looking at. Something very far away. You tell yourself, by 10 years time, this is what I want to be doing. By 10 years time, this is where I want to be. Begin to ask yourself, 10 years time, where will I be? Where do you want to be? Where will I be? It's not a question. Where do you want to be? And by 10 years time, surely you will be at the place. If you are not careful, you can even be in the grave. It's a place. 10 years time. We have so many places around the world. So 10 years time, you will be in one of them. So you need to write something down. 10 years time, where do you want to be? I told you there are some visions. When you have them in your eyes, you will never die. The vision will keep you alive. I gave you several examples. The vision you have will keep you alive. Even though this thing you did is time to die, but the vision will not allow you to die. The vision won't. It's too big, the world needs it, that God has to preserve you. He has to preserve you to bring this vision to pass. But if you are a man without vision, you don't have anything you are looking up to, you will only glory in the past. When we start talking, the only thing you will bring is something that was 1972. Those are the things you will be talking about, yet you were not there. Your grandmother was great, but she's gone. Leave her and talk about the future. All those great people who are no longer, they are not of any use. You are the one here, and you are the one the world needs now. So no need to be talking about any dead body, any. If your mentor is dead, what do you mean here? Because things they know and things that are happening these years, they are not the same. Archimedes was great, he didn't use Android phone. He didn't. He could not dial phone number from where he was to the next, even to the next city. But look at things that are happening around the world. Something happened within 2 minutes, you have it on your phone. You are very current. So there is no need to glory in those people with their laws. Their laws are good, but they should go. It's okay. They imparted their word. They left their name. What are you doing with your own name? What are you doing with your own name? You need to have a good mentor. Somebody that will mentor you into the future. Somebody that will talk you into the future. And when those people, sometimes when they come with a harsh voice, don't say they are demons. They are not. They are not. They are the ones that will help you in life. And you need to cooperate with them. Anytime, anything they tell you, say yes, I say yes, madam. I'll try my best. And when you put it away, tell them how far, how am I going? Always look for somebody that will be monitoring you from afar, from the way you are going. And ask them, am I going the right way? They say yes, continue, you go on. They say no, you are going the wrong direction, turn to the left. You need to have a person in your life like that. Don't live a hidden life. Only you are the only person who knows about your life. Nobody knows what you does in your private life. Nobody. That way, if you are going the wrong way, nobody will get to know. There are some people, even if you are going to their room, you have to appoint with them 1 week time. Because of what they are doing in there, they don't want anybody to come in, you know, they will get to see things. You need to appoint with them 1 week time. Is the guy president? No. He's just a student. First year student. You need to appoint with him 1 week time before you can see him. You shouldn't be such a person. Open your life so that people can see you and correct you. And when they correct you, don't be mad. Don't get angry. Say, well, I don't like the way you're talking to me. Talking to you. You haven't gone anywhere. We don't have anything at this age. So we need to humble ourselves so that God will lift us up. Bible says what? He said, God resists the proud. Any man, can you imagine? Most of you have never imagined. One day, I sat down to meditate on this scripture. God resists the proud. And I began to imagine how God will be resisting a man. God resisting a man. You can try it, meditate on it. Even if man is resisting you, it's not easy. How much more God resisting you? God resists the proud. And he gives more grace to the humble. I told you, when God gives a gift to a man, he does not take it back. God does not take his gift back. When he gives you with the talent to do anything, he does not take it back. But when you misuse it and you become proud, so proud with it, you know what you will do? He will raise another young, gentle guy beside you, and he will give him more grace that you so rise that even though you have your gift there, but that other guy's gift will overshadow you. That's what he does. He raises other people so high beside you that your gift is still there. He didn't take it back, but it will no longer be effective. You see, everybody is now running to that one. They want to be with that one. You are misusing the gift. That is why you see some people, even the gift in the house of God. God gifted a guy with the gift of tongues. You see him go and stand by the roadside. Oh, shaka. They want everybody to see he is speaking in tongues. Well, when that happens, you will be left with that whole shaka. There will be no improvement in your tongues. Any other gift God give you, there will be no improvement because he will cut the supply. And then you will be left with the little you have. So you need to humble yourself. You need to. Today this morning I was meditating on something, and I've realized some of you are too far away from me. It's true. You are too far away. You are too far away. You have problems that you need to come closer, but you won't. You won't. Another limitation of the human mind is that it only believes things that are communicated to it. You can write it down. The human mind only believes things that are communicated to it through the five senses. That is why you will hear somebody say, "Well, me, until I see it, I will not believe." Until you see it, you will not believe. That's your mind. And Jesus told the disciple, he told Thomas, he says what? He said, "Blessed are those who has not seen, but they believe." He said, "Blessed are they." Blessed are they. Sometimes you don't need to see it. From the way the thing is going already, you should know the future is great. You should know. You don't need anybody to tell you. Most of you, when we look at your life, from the way you are going, if you continue, your future is great. We can tell from now, your future is great from the way you are going. And from the way other people are going too, you can tell great is their distraction in the future. They won't go far. From the way they are going, they won't go far. If you are on and off in church, well, how will God bless you that way? How will God bless you that way? That is why if you go to every church, you see differences. They started the same day. The same amount of grace is being supplied to them. But you see, some treat the grace anyhow. They go to church when they want, when they like, is when they will show up. And the day they don't feel comfortable, they won't go. They go when all is well. I always tell you, if you are not feeling well, it's the day you should be in service. You still have to be in service. Try it and see. After service and see the feeling. The feeling is different. If you are not feeling well and you carry yourself to church, you are saying something to God. Say, Lord, you know something? I trust and I believe in your healing power. You don't need to come and pray. He will touch you. Bible says that he sent forth his word and healed them. He sent forth his word and healed them. You know, there are several things that you do. It's a demonstration of faith. When you do those things, you are demonstrating your faith. Sometimes you need to learn to test God. Lord, I am not feeling well, but no matter what, I am going to your house. It's a test. You are testing God. You are trying to push God to see. And don't tell him and say, well, I'm going to your house even though I'm not feeling well. If I come back and I'm not feeling and I'm not healed, I won't go next time. Don't do that one. Don't talk like that. He is God. You live for him. He don't live for you. He created you. You didn't create him. He existed far before you. And he have your life in his hands. He told the children of Israel, he told them, you know something? The heart of the kings, they are in my hands. And they should tell them, him, what he should do with it. That gave us a clue that children of God will have the power to control anybody. Because their heart, their life, their health is in the hands of our dad. And when we say, daddy, you know something, is causing too much trouble, turn the heart to the left, that's the result we will get. I told you, if there is somebody in your family misbehaving because he has some coins, some little money, so he's just misbehaving. Friend, you can take the job from him. When he becomes poor, he'll be humble. He'll be humble. You have the power to control your family. Just go on your knees. You don't need to call them. Go on your knees and begin to pray. Begin to declare words. You will see a change. You will see a difference. So, you need to if you are a man of the senses, you only believe things you see, things you hear, things you touch, things you feel, things you taste. You cannot be a spiritual person. You can't be. Because I told you the mind only believes things that is communicated to it through the five senses. If the thing is, that's why people who are carnal people, they don't believe spiritual things. Because you can't see God. So they said, well, how could you see there is God that we can't see? But they told the same guy, he has something called atom. He believed that one. He has never seen it. It's the smallest particle. He said, oh yeah, he can even draw it. He believed that one. He believed it. But they tell him there is God, he does not believe that one. They tell them you believing in God, he can turn your life around. He does not believe that one. But it is very possible. I told you when God created man, he never thought of man going to university to become a great person. God never thought of school system for any of his children. That is why you see God has principles. Anybody that will put the principle to work, whether you are educated or not, you will prosper in life. Go and find out so many people, they don't even know classroom where it is. They have the billions. They have the money. And they employ those who have been to the university and they determine their pay. If you misbehave, they will fire you. Yet the guy is illiterate, you don't know anything. You can speak all the English, all the grammar, he will fire you. Why? Because he put a principle to work. Yet he is not educated. I told you some people, the university they went to is actually the problem. If they were not to go to university, life would have been better. But they went to university, so he will become so big. I'm a university graduate, how do you expect me to be doing this? He's too big now. But if he were not to go to university and will start that little thing, he will see prosperity in it. He will prosper to become a very big person. That is the opportunity he has to start and to become a great person. But you know something? He is big. been to university, he read some few things, so he's big now. He knows. I'm a graduate. You are graduate, things you learn. Go and put them to where? Who are you waiting for? Who are you waiting for? I told you God created the world that everybody will have enough for himself. That was what God created. Enough. God never thought of anybody being employed by the other. God never thought of that system. That somebody being employed by another person. He planned the world that everybody will have enough. Even till today, the world has enough resources for everybody. But you know something? The mentalities are wrong. So people are seated down. People are there. They are crying of the government. They are insulting government. The government must employ us. Which whose job? The job came into being by the idea of somebody. And you are also somebody. Start your own. And also employ people. Stop sitting down and stop insulting presidents and governments. No. What you are studying today, study well. I told you, when you study well and you finish school, even if nobody employs you, you can start your own business or you can start your own thing. You don't need anybody to employ you. Most of you are not studying, you are reading. You are just brushing through the books. You are reading just to fulfill what classroom requires. You will fail if you continue that way. Those of you studying language, don't read those hands for the class. Learn to speak Chinese. That is the most important thing. Don't be busy, you know, trying to fulfill what the classroom is requires 100%. Yet you can't speak anything. When you speak ni hao, you say ni hao. No. Learn the accent. Learn very well. Learn very well. Learn very well. If you learn very well, if you go back home, even if you didn't pass whatever you are going, you can speak Chinese. It's an opportunity. It is. Chinese are now going to Africa to start business. They can't speak our languages, and when they realize you can speak, you become friends with them. It could be a big opportunity for you. It could be. So learn, and learn well. When you are learning, know how to learn. Anything you are learning, ask yourself, if I put it, what benefit will this thing be to me? And then learn those things that are practical, something you can put to work, and you can get a great result. Those are the things you should learn. Don't learn unnecessary things. It's very, very important. I told you, school system was programmed to make students suffer. If you don't know it, I'm telling you today. School was designed. Some people sat down and said, you know something, we are going to make life difficult for students. And they designed our school system in such a way that students will suffer it. I got to realize this thing when I was in high school. I broke loose of it. I thought something, you know something, I was not born to suffer and I will not suffer to any school system. I broke loose and I am free till today. No, nobody cannot sit down and design life for me to suffer it. How? How? I broke loose. I broke loose. And you need to begin to read things that are practical or things that make sense. There are several things, you know, you just spend your time, you're just wasting your time. And China here widens the opportunity. China here, there are so many things you can learn apart from your classroom work. You can even learn different things that you will find more fulfillment, that will give you more fulfillment than what the classroom is going to give you. They are all around. So don't spend all your time going only one way, one narrow way. No, you are in China, you are in a developed country. Widen your vision. Look, you have come across a lot of people from different countries. There's a lot to learn from all of them. Everybody seated here has something within them that you need. And don't look at a person from the person and say, I don't like this one. You don't have the right to say that. Sometimes the one you don't like is the one that carries your destiny. You don't know it. It's the one you don't like. And that's the work of the devil. He does it to so many people. People who carry their destiny, when they meet them, it causes trouble among them. So that your destiny will not come to pass. He did it to so many people. And it is still happening. It is. The world is vast. The world is big. So many things are happening always and every time. Decisions, people are taking decisions. And if you don't position yourself well, those decisions will affect you negatively. People you have around you, you must be careful. People you have around you. I was telling you, I don't know which people, that even sometimes the rising of your friend, if a friend around you is rising, sometimes if you are not careful, you will be affected. And you'll be affected negatively because somebody is rising. So you need to be careful people you have around you. Some people rose and others became poor. The guy was poor when he started a business. Let me give you the world example. When Samsung rose, Nokia, Siemens, Motorola, where are they? They are gone. When Samsung came into manufacturing phone, he kicked all of them out. Yet Nokia was one of the best phone ever. Where are they today? They are gone. When Samsung came into being, and they came for that purpose, they did it intentionally. And they are doing it to all other fields. They have started manufacturing air conditioning, all those air conditioning, they are going down. And they are doing it intentionally. They want to get everybody down. And they have the market, right? They have the market. Now Samsung phone is one of the best phones in the world. And they are doing everything to improve it. Just because they want to get people down. Now iPhone is their target. And they are doing it intentionally. They plan it. They are doing it intentionally. Now they want to reduce the market of iPhone. That is their chase. They want to bring them down. Do they want to be first? No, that is not what they want. They just want to tell them, you know something, somebody can rose from somewhere and bring you down. You are not actually the world champion. That's what they are trying to prove. Nokia had a lot of technologies. They were bringing it in bit. Samsung packaged all those things and put it in one phone and launched it to the world. And all those Nokia phones, they are now things of the past.